The problem is that many Christians today understand the separation of church and state to be a separation of God and state. This is likely due to the rise of secularism and one of its most effective lies, neutrality. Secularism insists that it is wrong for one group of people to impose their morality on another. As an alternative, secularism demands that the civil sphere be a morally neutral ground. But neutrality is a myth. Civil states have always and will always legislate morality. Take the issue of abortion, for example. Christians and other conservatives want to impose their morality on the mother and the abortion doctor by insisting that abortion is murder. But liberals and leftists want to impose their morality on the baby, aka killing it in its mother's womb, by insisting that abortion is a woman's right. When it comes to imposing morality, it's not whether, but which. There is no escape from legislating morality. The only question is this: whose morality will the state legislate? Will it legislate man's morality or God's? So although Christians should not advocate for a Christian state in the sense that the Christian church should govern the state, Christians must advocate for a Christian state in the sense that the state, although separate from the church, is not separate from God. And therefore, the state should earnestly seek to legislate morality according to God's unchanging standards rather than the constant evolving standards of the culture. I'm Pastor Joel with Right Response Ministries.